Hi everyone, welcome back to the React Scheduler grouping tutorial. In this video, I will explain about how to group the resources on scheduler layout both on calendar and timeline views. I will also let you know the other advanced grouping options available on Syncfusion React Scheduler. Here, if you look at this room scheduler, the timeline view is grouped with multiple resources where each row represents a resource. The appointment of each individual resources are displayed on its respective rows. Also, you can notice the resource in this timeline view grouped in two levels. This is just a simple example for how the resources are grouped in timeline view, but you can also see plenty of examples that exhibit the working of multiple resources and grouping from our React demo site. In this video, together with the grouping concept, I have also planned to explain about how to add shared events to the React scheduler, how to add different working days for each resources, how to group the resources date-wise, and how to make the row height to auto-adjust in timeline views. I hope you all might be excited by seeing these online examples. With that excitement, let me proceed to show you how to group the resource data to the React scheduler through code example now. I'm opening my existing React application now, where I have already configured the resource data during my previous video on multiple resources. So, if you're new to add resources data and its appointments to the React scheduler, then please watch my previous video and come back to this topic to have a better clarity and continuation. I have also shared that video link in the description part below. Now, let me directly move on to how to group the resources on scheduler layout. Here, I will define the group property, which is of object type. So, I'm defining a variable group data of type group model. To access this group model, I need to import it from Syncfusion EJ2 React Schedule package. Within this group data, I'm going to define the resource option, which accepts array of strings. Here, the strings are nothing but the unique resource names that are assigned to each resource within the resources property to identify them among the other resource collection. Now, for grouping the resources on scheduler layout, I'm going to define this unique resource name values within the resources property. Now, I will assign this group data variable to the group property of React scheduler. When you look at the output here, you can see each resource occupying its own space within the same scheduler layout, and the appointments of each resource are grouped accordingly in its own space. Now, I have simply shown how to define a single level resource hierarchy. But with the Syncfusion React scheduler, you can display n levels of resources by establishing the parent-child relationship. While defining the second level resource collection, the data source for the second level should be provided with an additional group ID field that maps with its predecessor data's exact ID value. So, to add another level of resources, I'm going to define one more resource directive tag within the resources directive now. To add data source to this resource level, let me first define a variable group data source of type array object, and I will pass three object collection with the fields name, ID, color, and group ID. I will map this name field to the text field option, ID field to the ID field option, color to color field option, and finally, group ID to the group field mapper option. Here, this group ID field will help you to map the particular resource under its predecessor data and let the scheduler to understand that it is a child data belonging to this parent resource. So, when I provide the value 1 for this group ID, it means that this is a child resource to the resource in the first level that has the same ID value as 1. Now, based on the second level resource data source, task 1 will be mapped under John and task 2 and 3 will be mapped under Steve, as both these resource matches the ID value as 2. And next comes the allow multiple property, where I have provided the value as true. By setting the value as true, you can select multiple resources on the editor window. And I will explain more about this while showing the output. Now, how will you relate the resources with appointment object when using multiple levels of resources? For this, I need to make use of this group ID field defined within this resource directive and should map its value inside the appointment object to the field group ID. Then, I need to set unique name for this resource to identify this particular resource from collection of resources. Okay, let me pass this unique resource name value to the resources property. Next, I'm going to add title for this resource, which will be displayed as label for the resource field in the editor window. And finally, I will assign the second level resource data source to the data source property of this resource directive. Now, when you look at the scheduler, you can see that the resources are grouped in two levels. So, at the first level, you can see John and Steve, and at the second level, you can see the resource Task 1, Task 2, and Task 3. You can notice that in the first level, James' resource is missing. This is because when you define two levels of resources, and if your second level doesn't have any mapper to the resource in the first level, then it will be automatically truncated from the layout. Have a look at these appointments that are grouped relevantly under its appropriate resources. Whenever you have multiple levels of grouping, the colors of the appointments are usually decided based on the colors assigned to the inner level of resources. So, the colors assigned to the task 1, task 2, and task 3 will be reflected on the appointments now. The important note here is the order of resources names that you pass to this resources property. Depending on this order, the resource will be grouped on the scheduler layout. Here, first resource name acts as a parent and the second resource name will act as a child that is mapped under the given parent resource. Now, let me remove the hide property from the scheduler to show you the adaptive resource layout in mobile mode. As the scheduler with the grouped resource is hard to view on the mobile mode, there is a compact mode available to view all the resources on mobile. So here, you can see the React scheduler in a compact mode and you can navigate between the resources as and when required. In this case, the scheduler viewport will show the appointments of the selected resource. Here, if you want to disable this compact view mode, then you need to set the enable compact view as false within the group property. Now, when you look at the same layout in mobile mode, you can see the same desktop version on mobile and you need to scroll to the right side to look at the entire resource. Okay, again I will set this hide property of scheduler and proceed to tell you the purpose of this allow multiple option of resources. When I double click on the cells, you can see here that the group name field will allow you to choose multiple options. But under this first resource name field, you will be able to choose only a single option. This is because I have provided the allow multiple property value as true for the second level resource collection so that I can choose multiple resource names. Next, I will show you how to group the resources based on date. You can see here that the scheduler is grouped based on resources by default. Suppose if I want to group the resource based on date, then I simply need to define the property by date and set the value as true within the group property of the React scheduler. So now you can see under each of these dates, the resources are grouped with its individual spaces. Another important functionality in grouping is linked events. There are scenarios where you may want to create appointments for multiple persons together in a single shot, and you may also want to edit them together on any changes. To enable such functionality, I need to set the option allow group edit as true within the group property. So now, when I create an appointment with multiple resources selected and simply saving this appointment, you can notice that two appointments grouped under respective resource. When I try to edit this particular appointment with a different title and changing the time, then you can see that the changes are reflected in both the appointments. In the same way, when you drag or resize any such linked appointments, you can see the changes reflecting on all the linked appointments. Okay, so far we have seen the resource grouping in calendar views. Now, let's look on to the grouped layout in timeline scheduler views. Here, you can see the resource and its relevant appointments as individual rows and task 1 is placed under John. Task 2 and 3 are placed under Steve. Alright, now let's have a quick recap about this session. We have seen how to group multiple resources in the React scheduler, where you simply need to define the group data source and map them with the required appointments. Also, we have seen how to select multiple resources on the editor window, as well as how to add and edit the linked events in group. And we have also seen how to group the resource based on dates in React scheduler. If you find this video as useful, then click the like button and subscribe to our channel too. Thank you for watching this video and stay tuned to watch our upcoming videos.